France mourns Doumer. And in the early morning, Paris sees the solemn mile-long cortege pass through the Place de la Concorde. Still stunned by the appalling tragedy of Doumer's assassination, the people pay their last tribute of silent homage. Slowly, the hearse passes upon its way from the Élysée Palace to the Panthéon, followed by Monsieur Lebrun, who succeeds Doumer as president. The Prince of Wales, the Duke of Aosta, and Prince Paul of Serbia are among the distinguished representatives of all nations of Europe come to convey the heartfelt sympathy of their countries. A solemn service will be held in keeping with the great citizen to whom the prince pays royal respects. Stricken with grief, Madame Doumer bravely endures her burden of sorrow. Her husband was beloved by all, and Monsieur Tardieu, the Premier, will deliver the funeral oration.
Altesse Royale, Mesdames et Messieurs, pour la seconde fois en 61 ans, la République a la douleur de conduire au tombeau son chef assassiné. Il touche à la majorité et armé du diplôme de licence, et voici qu'à 21 ans, il couronne l'ambition de sa raison. Deux fois ministre des Finances d'Aristide Briand. D'abord en 1921, le pays des droits de l'homme et du citoyen. Elle est aussi et elle restera la plus grande France.